In a decision that could have broad implications for biotechnology, the U.S. Supreme Court is set to rule on whether a private company can patent genes. The case centers around a suit filed against Utah-based biotechnology firm Myriad Genetics, which patented the BRCA1 and BRCA2 gene mutations back in the 1990s. As for the BRCA genes, you may have heard of them before. They're what forced Angelina Jolie to undergo a double mastectomy earlier this year. Women who inherit these mutations are about 5 times more likely to develop breast cancer. Myriad says it's allowed for second opinions and for thousands of other scientists to conduct their own research on these genes. To strike down the patents, it says, would discourage further innovation. But critics, including the American Civil Liberties Union, says Myriad's patent on the gene gives women no other choice but to pay the company $3,000 to test for it. Throwing out the patent would allow for cheaper testing. James Watson, who discovered the double helix structure of the DNA, had this to say in his friend of the court brief. The information contained in our genes lets us predict our future. This information should not be monopolized by any one individual, company, or government. SCOTUS Blog's Lyle Denniston says there are 2 options before the court. If it clamps down too hard on patent eligibility, it will kill the financial incentive for scientific innovation. But if it expands patent eligibility for such experiments too broadly, it will scare off other inventors who might also make breakthroughs if research were not inhibited by a patent monopoly. Either way, what does this mean for you? Well, according to NBC, not much. That's because the science has now moved far beyond the clunky whole gene sequencing method that Myriad uses, so it's becoming less relevant. Companies can now sequence your entire genome for you, and in a few years, they might even be able to interpret the information in a meaningful way. The Supreme Court is expected to make its ruling sometime this month. For Newsy, I'm Elizabeth Hagedorn.